Now we have to see parthenocarpy. Normally, ovary develops into fruit. After fertilization, ovary only develops into fruit. But in parthenocarpy is a process in which ovary develops into fruit without fertilization. When ovary develops into fruit without fertilization, that is called parthenocarpic fruits. Parthenocarpy is a process in which when ovary develops into fruit without fertilization, that process is called parthenocarpy. Parthenocarpic fruits are seedless fruits because seed formation takes place only after fertilization. When fertilization takes place in the ovary, then only the fruit will develop seeds. Such a fruits are called seedless fruits. Seeds are not produced in parthenocarpic fruits because they are not formed without fertilization. Many commercial fruits are made seedless. For example, banana, grapes, papaya. These are all the main fruit which does not contain fruit seeds, seedless fruits, parthenocarpic fruits. There are three main types of parthenocarpy classified based on the scientist Nitsch. Nitsch classified parthenocarpy into three types. One is genetic parthenocarpy, second one environmental parthenocarpy, third one chemically induced parthenocarpy. First one, genetic parthenocarpy. When parthenocarpic fruits are formed due to hybridization process or mutation process, induced mutation process, seedless fruits may be developed. Such fruits are genetically produced parthenocarpic fruits. Such a type is called genetic parthenocarpy. Second type, environmental parthenocarpy. Due to some environmental condition, seedless fruits may be produced. Environmental conditions like frost, fog, low temperature or high temperature that induces parthenocarpy. For example, in the case of pear fruit, if you treat the plant with low temperature for 3 to 15, 19 hours continuously, that will produce seedless fruits as far as pear plant is concerned. Third one, chemically induced parthenocarpy. Due to the application of certain chemicals, due to the application of growth promoting substances, particularly axin and gibberellin, that will induce parthenocarpy. In grapes, due to the application of axin, the seedless variety can be produced. So that is chemically induced parthenocarpy. Come to significance of parthenocarpy. The parthenocarpic fruits are very important as far as horticulture is concerned. Horticulture, growing fruit yielding plants, growing vegetable yielding plants. Study about fruit yielding, flower yielding, vegetable yielding plants. That branch is called horticulture. It is of great commercial value. Commercially, most of the people like only the seedless fruits. So it's very commercially important. For the preparation of jams, jellies, sauces, fruit drinks, most of the items, food items like this will be prepared from the parthenocarpic fruits. It has high proportion of edible fruits, then high proportion of edible part available due to the absence of seed. Seeds are absent here, so parthenocarpic fruits contain high proportion of edible part, that is not fruit, edible part available. So these are all the four important significance considered mainly. Great importance in horticulture, great commercial value, preparation of jams, jellies, sauces, fruit drinks possible, high proportion of edible parts are there in the parthenocarpic fruits due to the absence of seeds. So that is about parthenocarpy and parthenocarpic fruits.